Hey there, gamers, and welcome to Critical Damage, Emerson's only video game show. I'm your host, Piper Hall, and today I want to ask you, what was the first video game you played? For many, it was some variation of Mario. For others, it was one of those online games like Club Penguin or Animal Jam. In my case, it was Webkinz. But for many others, it was a licensed game. But what exactly is a licensed game? A licensed game is a game that is made by a company based on the intellectual property of another. Oftentimes, this is a tie-in to a popular movie franchise, book, or TV show. There have been some successful licensed games, like the recent Spider-Man 2, which boasts over 10 million units sold. But this is somewhat of an outlier. Most licensed games don't sell as well, and are considered to be nothing but soulless cash grabs by large companies. But is that actually the case? Are there good things to be found in licensed games? Well, today I will be joined by JR and Madison to discuss what exactly gamers' feelings are regarding licensed games. So, JR, I gotta ask you, do we really need licensed games?
I'm so glad you asked that question. I mean, I think, as in the case of all video games, there's good and there's bad. And licensed games usually are really fun. And I just love, like, as my favorite characters, like the Spider-Man 2 game, that has a special place in my heart. I did not like it as much as Spider-Man 1, but like being able to be Spider-Man, like that's like every kid's dream. And as I am still a child at heart, even though I am the ripe age of 45, I love being Spider-Man.
Oh, you look amazing for 45.
Yeah. Wow, you're doing great.
It's a lot of Botox.
Oh. Yeah. I think it almost feels a little bit like trashy television.
Yes.
Or like junk food. It's like, okay, this isn't like the best game. Like, this isn't...
To me, they're the best games.
They're the best games. They're probably not going to win that many awards unless they're a Marvel game.
Unless they're Baldur's Gate.
And
yeah.
Well, Baldur's Gate... Is Baldur's Gate a licensed
Dungeons
game?
I would like to argue it actually is, because think about it. How much of Baldur's Gate is Dungeons & Dragons? How, like, you couldn't even play the game without Dungeons
yeah.
& Dragons.
Yeah.
The whole point is rolling dice and playing the archetypes of the game. So I'm going to argue, and you guys can come at me later. I'm behind the studio. Y'all can fight me there.
Okay.
But I would argue that Baldur's Gate 3 is a licensed game because, yes, it can exist separately, and it is a really good game, which is why people don't want to give it that title. But it's Dungeons & Dragons
yeah.
on computer.
Yeah.
You just spacebar instead of rolling an actual dice. So I would argue, yeah, that's a great licensed game, and that's an example of it done really well.
Yeah, mm-hmm. really, really well. So do you think there is a stigma with these licensed games? Is that why Baldur's Gate isn't considered one?
Yeah, I would say there's definitely a stigma. I mean, we've all been there during the DS, like, licensed game, like, bonanza, if you guys have ever played Hannah Montana on tour. Yeah, no, the part where you'd play a rhythm game where all you had to do was spin your nunchuck
yeah.
really fast and you'd still get perfect.
Yeah, yeah.
So, like, there's a ton of those games out there because I think there's two games you need. There's two things you need to make a licensed game work. The mechanics you make need to reflect what the characters, what the people think the characters do. Like in Spider-Man, you need web-slinging. If you didn't have that, like, bro.
It wouldn't be a Spider-Man.
No. And you also, studios need to be willing to give away control over their beloved characters. When you make a game, that character's not yours anymore. It's whatever the player wants them to be. And Spider-Man's great because have I tried to throw people off walls? Yeah. But it's still, like, it lets me do that while also still being Spider-Man.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I think there's a lot. There's a lot.
Yeah. So do you think that these licensed games have creative value?
I absolutely think so. I mean, I think, as we were talking about before, the stigma, I feel like there's a huge stigma that these games are for children,
yeah.
that most of the licensed games are aimed for children. But I think we're seeing more and more.
They're not all the battle for Bikini Bottom.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, that was really good.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there is a solid genre and a market for licensed games that are meant for adults.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I feel like we're just beating Spider-Man into the ground with this one.
Fortnite. Lady Gaga and Fortnite.
Lady Gaga's
in Fortnite?
Have you not?
Yes.
I don't play Fortnite.
I would actually like to
see. You're about to.
That Ariana Grande being in Fortnite was the reason that I actually started playing Fortnite like 3 or 4 years ago. Have not stopped since then, and that is she is the problem for me. And then Lady Gaga reignited that issue, so
yeah.
there is absolutely a very big market for that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so do we think, like, with these games, with licensed games, have we seen an improvement, like, in quality? Because I know a lot, we talk about, like, the DS games, licensed game, or the Wii games, and they were, like, kind of, like, low quality. They kind of was what built the stigma around licensed games. But have we seen them get better over time?
I would argue yes, because they learned that they don't need to release the game the same time the movie comes out. Like, the first licensed game everybody quotes as, like, the worst ever was the E.T. game. That was meant to release with the E.T. film, and then like Indiana Jones meant to release with that film, which meant you were on a serious crunch time. Mm-hmm. Now, like, I haven't seen a new Spider-Man movie in like a while, and the game isn't even related to that film at all.
Yeah.
So I think that studios realizing they can spend time to make it actually good is what has helped licensed games overall get a lot better over the past few years.
Yep. A great point to make with that is, yeah, the stories are original. They're not one-to-one with, like,
exactly.
They're not promotional material. The thing that was bad about them was they're meant to promote the movie. They're mm-hmm. meant to just serve as a companion piece and not their own separate things. And so these studios that own these franchises are now allowing just a lot of creative control for the video games. We're seeing that with, although the Star Wars EA stuff has been give and take, we're seeing that they are showing a large amount of creative control over it. With that Star Wars Squadron game, that was weird, but it was a complete niche that was like, had full creative control over that. We're like, we're gonna make a game for the people who love to fly these fighters. And so it's just, they're completely separate now, and that's amazing.
Yeah, I think it definitely, like, when you give the companies more time and let them have more freedom with what they can do, it really helps to improve the games.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to ask, what licensed game would you like to see?
Ooh, you're gonna have to come back to me on that one.
What about you, JR? A Housewives game? A Kardashian? Actually, the Kardashians game already
Kim
exists.
Kim Kardashian, yeah. Hollywood is going to be off the market in like a couple weeks. Yeah, they're shutting Kim Kardashian Hollywood down.
Wow.
Which is so sad. I have spent so many hours on that. I really like horror games. So I like the licensed horror games a lot, and I think they're really unique and interesting. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre game that came out a little while ago, I actually really, really loved that. And I haven't played that in a hot second, but it's so fun and it's so unique. So, I mean, Scream is my all-time favorite franchise, so seeing that in a video game would be amazing.
Maybe a Megan game would be fun.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, Megan. Yeah. Or Megan in Dead by Daylight, because like a whole other genre of like licensed stuff is licensed DLC, and Dead by Daylight and Fortnite have really cornered that market. So I love seeing these iconic like horror like characters in like a Dead by Daylight universe, and you see the unique mechanics that they bring in.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Well, what else do we think? What's another one?
Guys, my favorite TV show, and like I don't think it could ever be made into a game, is Castlevania. Mm. Like that's such a great
show
that like I don't know how you could ever make that.
Yeah.
I love the series. Castlevania Nocturne absolutely wasn't as great as the original, but the show is 10 out of 10. But yeah, like I just couldn't see that becoming a video game. I don't know what would you, vampires in video games? Like how does that work? How?
I've
never seen one.
Yeah.
For those of you who don't know, it is a game. We don't have all gamers watching this show. I know, it's a little crazy.
Not a gamer, what are you doing here, dog?
There are parents.
Oh yeah, we love the parents. We love you parents. Yeah, without you, we wouldn't exist.
Yep, that is true. Yeah. So what would you say is your favorite licensed game that you've played?
Do you have one?
Battlefront 2.
Okay.
The newer version. I love Stormtroopers.
Yeah.
Pew pew.
Oh, for the Stormtroopers?
I am a huge Star Wars fan. Guys, I hope you know all these props over here are mine. I am the Star Wars and the Spider-Man props. I love Stormtroopers, and like I said, the fact that I'm given creative control over a little Stormtrooper, and I can try my hardest against Luke Skywalker to my heart's content is just amazing. I love it, and it doesn't even need to be that great to work.
Okay, I just remembered my answer, and it's the Batman Arkham games.
Ooh, that's a good
so
one.
Hard to decide which one I like more because it changes like every single day. But right now it's Batman Arkham Knight. I love the mechanics in that. The tank, frustrating, but I can look past that. The stories of all of those games are so just incredibly unique and fun. Very upset with what they did with the Suicide Squad game. Did I complete it? Yes, but. Hey, we're here.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry for my sanity.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I don't know. See, I don't know if this counts, but I am a big fan of Just Dance. And
yeah.
That's kind of a license.
You know what?
Game.
Yeah.
Because they license the music.
Well, because they have Lady Gaga lore in that thing.
Yeah.
They totally do. Yeah.
They have Lady Gaga lore.
That
so Rasmussen, you know,
song, that dance turns me up. I love Boogie into that one. Mm. Turns me up.
Okay.
So do we think licensed games are a good thing or a bad thing?
Amazing. I love having fun. I love to laugh, and I love to see my favorite characters in any capacity that they're willing to be.
Yeah.
I mean, it like with everything in video games, you need to take care of the source material, and you need to have care for the story and the game mechanics, or else you're gonna get a bad game. Like, you need to just be good and have fun while making video games. That's what's important.
Mm-hmm. I would say, at least for me, I think licensed games started off as something bad. They were just cash grabs, but now we've seen a kind of shift where they're becoming their own entities and they're actually improving a lot, besides just the Marvel games, which is kind of what people assume.
Yeah, no, I agree. I always like to quote, I used to be a beta tester for Fortnite, fun fact, and I thought the game was horrible. And then it comes out and it's this huge big hit, and that's kind of my opinion on licensed games. I thought they sucked, and then I started playing them and I was like, wow, there's like some great stuff you can do here, just like you said. When you put care and love into it, you're gonna get a lot of love back.
Mm-hmm. So, do we really think that licensed games are super creative?
I mean, yeah, I think a big thing that I just thought of with your point that you just made, I think the growth of licensed games and the creativity also has a direct correlation with the respect of video games as like an art form and not as like secondary or less than. Video games are truly seen as their own independent thing that have different mechanics and different like uses than like movies and TV. And so because of that, like all these like studios who own these IPs are now being like, oh, we can fully get into this and make completely original stories that are also in the same universes as these licensed, as these like big IPs, and I think that's really great.
Yeah, no, I would agree. I think the more limitations you have in a game, like just anything creative, you know, any limitations you have are always gonna foster more creativity. And like the idea of taking a film, a concrete story, and then trying to give it mechanics as well as giving it a new ending, multiple endings, is incredible. Like, that's a lot of stuff you have to think about that, like, you can't do that with a film. You can't think about, how am I gonna make web swinging feel like it does in the movie? I've never swung a web before. How am I gonna know how that feels? So, like, and also, like, it's just, it's wonderful. I'll stop talking now.
All right. Well, thank you guys for joining me for this discussion, and I guess I will see you in the variety segment soon. So I think it's about time to throw it over to Aiden and Tanner for our first frame news. Take it away.
I'm Jamie Sanders, host of MTV Games, and welcome to my set! Where are the contestants? I lost the contestants. Where are the Oh, hey there. I'm Jamie Sanders, host of MTV Games. What am I doing in a ball pit? Hello? Hello? What am I doing in a ball pit? I'm all alone. Please watch the show.
Thanks, Piper. Welcome to First Frame News. I'm Aiden.
I'm Tanner.
Let's get into it. Recently, Valve released the Steam Families beta, an overhaul of Steam Family sharing. Now, groups of up to 16 users can share their entire game library with one another, with few restrictions. The previous version, Steam Family Sharing, was unfortunately locked to specific regions with only one player able to access an individual's library at a time. Now, I can play my friend's copy of Street Fighter with my own save data and achievements, even if they're online and playing another game in their library. Valve has stated that this feature is intended on being used between family members, and they will reevaluate how the feature affects their platform in the future.
Xbox may be making a handheld. According to a quote from Ches Gordon, the managing editor of Microsoft news site Windows Central, Xbox is working on an all-digital handheld console. Gordon claims games could run natively, and Xbox already has physical prototypes. If this leak is to be believed, it means that Xbox will be competing against the Switch and Steam Deck, marking a shift in the handheld market. It's also yet another sign that they are gearing their business towards an all-digital future, emphasizing their Game Pass library.
Is Tekken getting a Waffle House stage? After a barrage of requests asking for one, Tekken 8 producer Katsuhiro Harada took to Twitter to ask why. Users explained to him the cultural significance of the breakfast chain restaurant, including its lengthy history of kitchen brawls and parried furniture. Harada thanked everyone for their explanations and said that, quote, "The restaurant has both the trademark and the rights to the restaurant, so if the restaurant chain's headquarters refuses to accept my proposal, it will not happen," end quote. This statement seems to indicate that Harada may be on board with the idea, and I will finally have a reason to pick up Tekken 8.
Margot Robbie's production company Lucky Chap will produce a Sims movie. Along with Vertigo Entertainment, Loki's Kate Herron would direct and co-write the screenplay. Electronic Arts, publisher of the games, will also be involved. Little is known beyond that, but fans are curious how the film will tackle adapting the games, which don't have any plot. After the success of Lucky Chap's Barbie, which faced a similar challenge, fans are eager to see what they come up with. But I do wonder, will the entire movie be in Simlish?
Microsoft has recently released a dynamic wallpaper for Blue Dragon, an Xbox 360 title with art and characters designed by the late Akira Toriyama. Akira Toriyama tragically passed away on March 1st, 2024, due to an acute subdural hematoma. Akira Toriyama was well known for his iconic Dragon Ball franchise. However, he also worked on multiple games as a character artist and designer, such as for Chrono Trigger or the Dragon Quest franchise. I grew up playing many licensed Dragon Ball games, and I still remember the Dragon Ball FighterZ launch day, how impactful it was to so many. His stories and art inspired and continues to inspire millions of people every day, and his passing has been felt throughout the world. Rest in peace, Akira Toriyama.
Sega of America employees have ratified a union contract, making them the first major American video game company to do so. The new contract protects around 150 members and includes yearly pay raises, notices about plans of AI, and most importantly, notifications about layoff plans and severance. This is significant after waves of layoffs in the past few years at other video game and tech companies such as Microsoft, Unity, and Sony, with an estimated 4,600 jobs lost between only those three. While there are still some issues to cover, such as the scourge of crunch time, this new contract is certainly a welcome step in the right direction. Back to you, Piper.
And when I arrive at my destination, I am gonna kill Bill.
What?
Oh! Okay, cutting. Sorry, can we get some of these lights?
Where in God's name is the gaffer's tape?
Hi, I'm Nate.
And I'm Casey, and we're the National Broadcasting Society.
Come out to some of our weekly workshops, or work on some of our sets.
Explore the bigger picture with NBS.
We'll see you there.
All right, let's get another take. Camera, sound.
So yeah, it's like Emerson's very own late night talk show. We've got games, like Jimmy Fallon, and we're hot, like Jimmy Kimmel, and we've got guests. I'm gonna talk to him. You can talk too, I guess. There's a live studio audience and they're just gonna laugh at everything we say and it's gonna be awesome. It's just this never-ending cycle of positivity and community and late night content. I'm gonna wear a suit. You should probably wear one too. What do you think?
I think you should drink up because it's closing time.
All right, coming back in 10 seconds. Ready, camera one. Camera one, you're gonna wide shot the entire thing, and in three, two, one, take. Town view.
Welcome back to Emerson College. Emerson Trails.
Camera 4 getting a shot of the players coming across the court.
10 seconds left. Emerson trails by 1 point.
Camera 2 close upon the first and shooting.
Thanks, Joe. With 10 seconds left, Emerson is hoping to pull away and score this
game. Camera 1 getting close to follow them over.
Emerson Trails.
Camera 1 close up on number 33.
Thanks, Joe. 10 seconds left. Emerson's
ball. Follow the ball, follow the ball.
Licensed games. Well, today I will be putting my fellow host to the test. In this game, there will be two rounds, each with four licensed games. For each game, the host will have to first guess how many units were sold of that game, and second, what the Metacritic score is. These will be guessed separately, so there will be 2 points to be won for each game. After the first round of games, we'll be taking a quick break before jumping into our next round of games. So, let's get started. Now, you guys might have been able to see, our first game is Peter Jackson's King Kong, the official game of the movie.
Ooh.
That game.
That like 2 days ago.
Oh, okay. So you might have an advantage
here. No, I
here.
Don't. They just talked about how cool it was.
I saw a YouTube video.
The units sold.
I was like,
how many units sold?
Oh,
do you think?
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
Is this the PS2 version?
I didn't.
Well, yes maybe. But
PS2.
Oh.
Okay. 2005 by Ubisoft.
Okay. PS2 is gonna inflate this number a bunch.
You know, I'm gonna stick to it.
Okay.
I'm just not, you know what, don't look.
I saw it.
I think I got it.
I didn't copy it, if that's what you're wondering.
You better not.
I definitely don't
I copyright it.
All right, are you guys ready to show your answers?
Let's do it.
All right, what have we got?
4 million.
30 million.
72.39 million, Piper, I love you.
Oh, well, thank you for that, but the closest is Aiden at 4 million. So. It is 4.5 million.
Oh,
that's
very
crazy.
Close there.
Wow.
That's actually crazy.
So now erase your boards.
Ooh.
With your hands. We don't have erasers here. We can't afford them here at Critical.
You gotta use the knuckle.
Please give us money.
You gotta use the knuckle.
All right,
so
next you have to guess the Metacritic score for this game.
Ooh.
Do you think this game was well received?
The movie
wasn't,
right?
No.
The movie was iffy.
That ride at Universal Studios, though, fire.
All right, let's take a look. 12, 82, 63, and
79.2934.
That's a 76.
Mine says yay.
They round up.
76.29.
All right, Madison is closest.
Yeah!
Really?
80.
Wow.
That's right.
Wow.
I'm alpha. Take that.
I was close, though.
Right. No, you weren't.
That's really rude. Wow.
I should have more faith in King Kong.
Beefing on the critical
damage. The next game we have is Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, the game.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh my gosh.
That game got
delisted. This whole board is blue. My hand is blue.
This is the money, right? The units.
But like,
Now this game came out in 2021, also by Ubisoft. Now, I'm sorry, I have to add this. This is the first weekend how many units were sold.
Oh.
So it's gonna be a lot lower of a number.
Okay. I still can't count though, so it's fine.
All right, are we ready?
No, I changed my mind.
You can't change your mind. As clearly shown, this does not erase.
I'm ready.
All right, let's see. 4 million.
4 million,
I think. 40,000.
What is, that?
690,000, huzzahs.
That looks like Z million.
Oh, Z? Million. No, that's a two.
4 million, I didn't even know this existed.
All right, once again, Aiden.
Really?
Oh.
It is 45,000 in the first weekend.
I would have gone with like a million, but or like a million-ish, but then you said first weekend, and I was like, oh.
Yeah, it's a short time frame, so it's going to be a shorter.
This is for all the games.
Number.
Is it? Okay. Yeah. Is it weekend, first weekend for all the games?
No.
Okay, just that one.
Just
that one. Funky. Oh.
My board is blue. My hands are blue. For it.
Oh, hello.
All right, and what do you think the Metacritic score of this game is?
It looks nice.
Yeah, I know.
I love
it. Really does look cool.
Game.
Girl, everything looks nice on the cover.
Oh, that's true.
Even King Kong?
Even me.
Have you seen King Kong?
True.
That's what I thought.
All right, have we got a score?
You're...
All right, let's see who's closest. Oh, and keep track of your points because I'm going to try my best, but I don't know how close I'll be. All right, I believe the close. Okay, that says 53?
That says 53.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mine says 68.999, and also that he's wrong.
What?
All right, once again, Aiden is the closest.
Oh,
wow.
It had a Metacritic score of 77.
I don't know about that.
Count your days.
And count with this many fingers.
I'll count my days.
This many fingers.
With this many.
I'll count my days and my 3 points, which I have and you don't.
Oh, wow.
All right. What if I quit?
Okay.
What if I quit
Someone's
right now?
Someone's face is about to get a mustache. I swear to God.
All right, this next game is one that I played when I was younger. This is the Littlest Pet Shop game.
Is this lifetime sales or first weekend?
Lifetime sales.
Okay.
Are you dissing the game right now?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, if anything, I'm underballing it.
It was released in 2008 by EA.
Okay.
Oh, EA.
It had 4 subsequent games afterwards, actually.
Oh, that's
interesting.
That may have just changed my number.
Oh, wait, this is the... Oh, I'm doing the wrong metric this time.
Hey, it can be the same number, just like...
Give me a second.
You could have only sold, 10 copies.
A Littlest Pet Shop game on the Wii, that's going to be up there.
All right. Let's see those numbers.
See the numbers.
11 million, 3 million, 2.3, and 12. Aiden, you're killing me.
Are you serious?
It is 3.5 million.
Clearly someone here is a writer.
The door is right.
I left.
We're all writers except for you.
All right, and now
remember that plan I told
is the Metacritic score. What do you think about this amazing game where I would take care of my littlest pet shops?
Oh my God, this is all over my hand. It looks like I murdered a Smurf. Ooh, you know what?
You were ready.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look.
45 million and he's, 45% and he's toast.
Oh.
Well, he is toast because you are closest. The Metacritic score is 40.
I did 47.
You're toast.
I'm toast.
How does it feel to be a delicious snack?
Yo, how many points you got?
Whoa.
Oh. I don't like that.
This isn't a safe work environment anymore.
I'm letting it get to my head a little bit. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
All right, and the next one is a really popular game. It is The
really?
Witcher 3 Wild Hunt.
Oh my God.
Ooh.
How many units sold do you think this has?
I keep forgetting.
It's
gotta be a lot.
Is it launch sales, lifetime sales, all the different
I believe
versions?
It is lifetime sales.
Okay.
People care a lot about The Witcher.
I'm just gonna imagine that I'm right.
What do you love, JR?
I don't know yet. I'm trying to figure out.
Aren't we all?
I'm not going to say it yet, but you think.
Okay.
All right, let's see those answers.
You think every person on Earth bought The Witcher 3?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Closest is Tanner with 20 million. It was actually 50 million.
50.
Woo!
Oh, it is? You have 25?
Yeah.
Oh, then Ada.
Oh my God.
Why?
I have.
Why?
Not to steal your thunder.
Why?
Unbelievable.
Oh, of course you'd be the one correcting the rules.
Yeah.
La La Land at the Emmys or whatever that was.
All
damn.
Right. And now, what do you guys think? What is the Metacritic score?
yeah, I'm going to do a nice
Oh, wow.
Oh, wait, I also need to write something now.
Guys, you spelled my name wrong.
Sorry.
Is this not how your name's
spelled? No, she spelled it wrong.
Okay.
You spelled it right.
Okay, I'm illiterate.
But you just spelled it wrong. Yeah. But is that right or wrong?
No, that's wrong.
Okay, yeah, that's wrong.
Yeah, she's just not changing.
Fix it, okay.
All right, now the Metacritic score. Let's take a look at those scores. Wow, okay, well, Aiden is closest again.
This is why I wrote Aiden Poopy.
It was 92.
Oh, wow, I actually overshot it. I really thought The Witcher 3 was...
Read this.
Yeah, people love The Witcher.
He's cheating, arrest him.
Someone stop him.
All right, now, while you guys erase your boards, I think it's time to take a quick break and take a look at some amazing indie games.
Look at my
finger.
Look at my hand. Your hand is...
Raw Metal, an intense pedal-to-the-metal action game by Team Crucible. Take control of a lone robot as you sneak into the depths of a mining facility and fight against a deeply corrupt megacorporation. Checkmate Showdown. Mix the strategy of chess with the flow of fighting games in this mashup by Manavoid Entertainment. Play a new version of chess where every interaction leads into a traditional 2D fighting match. Slay the Princess. Dive into a monochrome world in this horror visual novel by Black Tabby Games. Every little choice matters, and don't believe the lies of the princess. Curio City. Take a break in this cute adventure game by Bread on Board. Take control of a rookie adventurer and a newbie healer and inform their journey as they dive deeper into their quest. That's all for our indie game shoutout. Now back to the show.
Welcome back to our licensed game. Just to recap, it looks like Aiden is way ahead of everyone else. Good job, Aiden. But there's still, I think at least, there's still time for you guys to take the lead. Now, we're going to start with the... You good?
Yes. I already
we are
did
going
that
to start with the PlayStation 2 game, The Fantastic Four.
Oh,
God. Oh.
This was from 2005 by Activision.
No, you don't.
You live two doors down from me,
dog. I thought you meant my house.
Oh,
I
do know that, too.
Sorry,
I have
All right. What do you guys think for this Fantastic Four game? Still, what does two mean?
To what?
It can mean whatever you want it to mean, I guess.
All right.
Whatever is closest.
2K.
Well, it is Madison is the closest.
That's right. That's right.
look
up upon me.
I'm being put down.
All right, and now it's off to the Metacritic score. What do you guys think?
Oh. People hate that movie, don't they?
No, it was fantastic.
Oh, it was
fantastic. It was fantastic.
The first one
awful.
Is actual art.
Okay. Sure. I don't know why I drew a six like that. I don't draw. I write. Wait.
All right. It's time for the Metacritic score. What do you guys think? That just says it's fantastic.
That's because it is.
All right. Well, Madison, you seem to know the Fantastic Four because this Metacritic score is 62.
That's right. The alpha's coming in game.
You're Piper. I don't. Never mind. Nope. Never mind. I'm done talking.
What,
I can't.
Was yours
nope.
Closer?
No, it wasn't. I'm stupid.
50, yeah.
Math is not my strong suit.
Oh, we are at Emerson.
Yeah.
Hey, I can count to five.
And that episode's banned.
All right. Our next game is for the GameCube, and it is Pixar's Cars.
Ooh.
How do you think this did? Released in 2006.
Cars is a big franchise.
Cars are a big franchise.
Yeah. Slightly unrelated, but one Christmas, me and my group of friends, we got my one other friend every version of Cars 3. Just
oh, wow.
He doesn't particularly like Cars. We just thought it'd be funny.
Okay, then, what do you guys think?
Madison hates Chipotle.
I drew a car.
Yeah.
What is the 95
million?
For?
95,000? Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Aiden, you are the closest. It was 8 million.
Oh. Okay.
I don't know about that.
I need to start breathing or else I'm gonna go crazy up
here.
What if
I just like bought a bunch of whatever the next game
is? So that you win?
Yeah, exactly.
I...
whatever the number is, you're gonna order 5 million copies so you're closer.
All right, so Metacritic score, what do you guys think?
Oh,
12, what? Wow, that's pretty low.
Quick, someone write 13.
Piper, what's your favorite, what day were you born?
The 22nd. Oh, well, thank you.
Okay.
Oh, you stink.
All right, the closest is Aiden. It
the
is
one
a
time I don't do it.
I'm pretty sure Aiden has won this, but we're going to keep going anyway.
For hey, these, I can believe.
No,
for these final two games.
You know, who has the moral victory?
Me.
I had the most fun.
Who's the tallest? Who's the tallest?
Guys. Oh. Guys. Guys.
Okay, let's move on to our next one. Dragon Ball Z, The Legacy of Goku.
Oh, God. Oh. Like the one Dragon Ball game I don't have an answer for.
It was released for the Game Boy Advance.
Dragon Ball.
It was
7 million.
1 point.
Okay,
I wrote
can't just say over 9,000.
I wrote 1.6 if you can't read it.
I honestly think he earned
once again, Aiden is the closest.
You can,
it was 630,
honestly, I like your answer.
You
like I think you got it, to be honest.
A little honorary point.
You can
thank
have
you.
That one. That was the correct answer.
My hands are blue and for what?
Oh, no.
Stop laughing at my misery.
You're bored.
Look at this. Look at this.
All right, and we are moving on to the Metacritic score.
Oh.
What do you guys think?
Oh, I can't do the same joke twice.
I know, neither. I've
got to think of some more things.
I haven't done a double number.
Oh, all of them.
You've been going all single digits.
Yeah. 55 yeses. Oh, I just said my answer. I'm dumb.
That's okay.
That was spiteful.
Did you also write 55? You? That's really funny.
All right. Well, Madison wrote 55 first.
What?
And that is
that's
the
right.
closest.
Crazy. True alpha wins.
It
that's
was
right. 50. Sit down.
So when I cheat, I don't win.
No. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
All right.
That's really rude.
And we've moved on to our final game, which is a game I really like. This is The Walking Dead, the Telltale Definitive Series, except this is just season one.
Yeah.
How do we think season one sold?
That's a zombie game, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, it is, sweetie.
So, what'd you just call me?
Oh.
I mean, what'd you just call me? Sweetie.
Okay, all right.
All right, anyway.
Answer.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I think I said this number before, but it's okay. No thought is original.
Okay, wow. All right, 1.2.
That's 12.
That's 12? Okay. Madison, you are the closest. It sold 8.5 million.
I wrote 12.
I thought
you both wrote 12?
Yeah.
Okay, you can have a point too
this
time. But I'm pretty sure Aiden has won at this point.
It's not over yet. We still got one more.
One more.
What do you? I physically cannot win if I win both.
The Metacritic score.
Oh my God.
The final one. What do we think?
Yeah. Did you just also?
Pure coincidence, I swear.
Okay,
I
so then we can share it. Do you want halves if we win?
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, yeah.
Whatever Madison wrote.
What the heck, guys?
All right, so if it's anything not 90 or above.
Well, 90. I think Aiden is the king of this game because it was 82.
Dude.
On the nose.
Where? Witchcraft. Witchcraft.
I'm actually just a prophet.
Witchcraft and blasphemy. You did something.
Guys. So I guess.
Can I rip these in frustration?
They're telling us no. All right.
You have to clean it up.
Well,
I'm not saying anything.
I would clean it up.
Aiden, congratulations. How many points did you get?
I'm sad to report I didn't hit double digits. We're only at 9 points.
Oh,
that's a win.
I'll get them next time. I'll get them next time.
That's too bad.
All right.
Oh, boy. All right. Well, congratulations, Aiden. And I think that wraps up our show today. I want to thank our amazing Evie-nominated producers, Ben, woo! Gabri, and Ross, for all their hard work on this show the past few seasons. I want to thank our amazing writers and crew for everything they do here at Critical Damage. And I want to thank you, our viewers, for watching our show. That's all for this season, and we'll see you next time. Bye, gamers!